You're gonna hate me for this, but I'm not happy with my ape. I think I might do him over. I love the background, but I really, now I'm not happy with him. Maybe I need him to be brighter. Let me see. No, I think I want to redo him. Okay, I'm going to do this again. And what was... Okay, we're going to get rid of that. And... Actually, let's just get rid of all of this. We'll do a brown background. What I want to do is, where's my brushes? My favorites. Here we go. I'm going to get my, I think I'm going to do sketching. We're going to do it in white. We're going to start over and we're going to some of the color to stick out. So I'm going to create my white layer. And I do this knowing full well that this is the long way around. People who have more experience in digital painting, it doesn't take them as long as it takes me to do my paintings. But I'm okay with that because I like the textures. I'm definitely a novice, but I'm learning every single time I do something, and sometimes like this one, I do it over, and that's perfectly fine. It doesn't have to be perfect in my book, just creative and artistic. And so that's what I'm doing here, and now I can make my brush larger. Some areas here. Let's bring this down. Okay. I know I'm larger than I need to be, but that's okay. Okay. Now we're going to bring you down. Face. I don't have a color palette for his face. That's my kid. Okay, I'll just... Nope, don't want that either. Let's just do the disc. Okay. So, I really kind of want him to be a little bit dark. And let's get my favorite brush. Whoa! Did I do the feet? Darn it, I may not have done the feet. face. Now we're going to do the body, and the body is going to be, let's do like a golden. Already liking this. Just want to get the base color down, and then we can add highlights and details with a smaller brush, pencil brush, or even this one. And so here you can see it's what's the word I'm looking for? It's a deeper. The contrast, this is light and this is darker because it's a layer I went over, so I'm gonna spread that out a little bit because I don't really want it like that. And then I am going to do a little bit deeper around here. Definitely like that, and I think I want to, just for texture's sake, spread that around a little bit. Take those hard edges off. Okay. Smaller because we're going to start defining. Totally. painterly. Whoops. Maybe not that. Okay. Oh, wait a minute. I need to go all the way down here. Wow. I wonder why it wasn't looking right. Okay, I'm liking it now. That is way better. All right. Not get that. Oh my gosh, I like him. He is cool. Okay. Definitely like him better. Look at that face. Look at that face compared to definitely gonna get rid of him. All right, you guys, he's going away. I'm gonna do it. Hands and feet, gone. Body, gone. Okay, and you, gone. Don't need you, delete. Okay, you're the tree, which I like very much. I'm gonna leave the tree on. I like the background, I like this. These guys are gonna go back here. And then I don't need you. I'm gonna get rid of, not you, this layer. Don't need it because I have my original to keep track of right here. Okay, whoops. Hobbles. That's my face. Look at the face. He's so happy. I love it. Okay. And then this guy. I think I need to get rid of some of him. So let me make sure I have my pencil on. So we're gonna put, what's this one? I don't know, but we're gonna put the eyes, and the face, and the hands in a group. I'm gonna name this group Face. Brush the qual. This one is more artsy and I like it. this a little bit better. Oh my gosh, look at him, he's so great. Just kind of pushing it around. Very painterly looking. That looks great. Look at that. I'm so glad I decided to redo him. Carl, which I named him. I'll show you the other one, the other video of all the work I put into it and then how unhappy I was with it. Carl, you look so great and so happy. This hand looks a little darker than this hand. On you later. But the face I'm loving. Okay. So we have these two, and I just don't think I want to merge yet because I want to build that color up a little bit more. And we're going to turn that brush down. We're going to be so up here on his head, I don't want it to go up as high because this is where the sun is coming through and I want to see those highlights in the back. But I definitely, it's going to have to be darker here because this is closer to his face. Have a love of red, and I am very happy with this color. Very happy. Let me blend that out a little bit more. Work on that blend. See the way that blends? Ugh, love it. He looks so great. Okay, I think I want to make it even that much more darker. I'm gonna make this blend even smaller. Oops. Not what I wanted to do. Okay. Ah, I love it. Okay, yeah, that's the face. All right, so let's get back to I'm whispering. You can't hear me when I whisper. I know. I know. I'm gonna have to dub it. Dub it, I think. Oh my gosh. Carl, you look lovely. Carl is a happy ape. You don't worry, they're not gonna look like noodles. I will blend them. You saw how I blended them. Also, I had some more highlights. I like the texture that this leaves behind. This looks fabulous. Oh my gosh, does he not look great? Look at him. He's so happy. Yep. He looks good. Not liking the way that's turning out. clear. And let me go back to my brush. All right, so I think I need a bigger brush. Okay, I'm trying to figure out how I want it to look, and I think I'm figuring that out right here. Right over it, kind of like a yellowy orange. This is what I love about digital art. I don't like that yellow now that I've put more down. Maybe I need to do a top layer of yellow. Oh, because that's not very bright. He's kind of cool looking. So that was the one I had, so maybe I need just a little bit darker. Gosh, I like him. Gosh, I like that. I like him. Very painterly looking. Oh my gosh. Okay, now I think I'm gonna go in with some pencil. 6B. I kinda want it to be a little darker. Okay, I really like him. My brush. Okay, let's try this over. There's a look I'm going for. You can probably figure it out. I want this to look more like. Thank you. All right, I really like him better. Okay, now, I definitely need to smooth. Just gives the impression of hair or fur, because it is a great ape. Let's see this one going sideways. I got rid of that. Carl, you are gorgeous. I love you, Carl. Yes, that I like way better. I'll do, okay, let me add some background. Let me turn you on. I don't know what that is. And hands, body, there we go, up in the tree, yes, oh, I forgot the apple, I like him, he's a great ape for sure. I like my qual. Thank you. Let's do... Okay, that's an apple. We're going to add a stem. How about... Where did he get an apple from? I have no idea, but that's... Like that. All right, now.
Whoops. Ugh.
That's not good. But look at him. Isn't he great? Okay. Let's merge the apple down because I'm getting a little overwhelmed. This is the body. Love the body. Hands and feet. Okay. Just showing up. All right, and we're gonna pencil. Wow, it looks way better with the yellow, the white underneath. I had the white gouache, but that was not enough, clearly, because look at him, he's really looking great now. See how the color we'll clean Carl the Ape up. You see that? There's a pencil line there, and I don't know where that's coming from. So, when you have too many layers like me, because you're not quite sure what you want. Oh, could it be that one? No. It's not there. It's gonna drive me nuts. What's going on here? All right, is it the tree? It's the tree. All right, so we need white under here. Because the apple is sticking through. I don't want that. Okay. Nice. You're good, and then we're going to close you up because we're not working on you, and then we're going to come back and turn you off, and then we're going to come back here, and we need to fill this. Back on, and then we will clean up these edges with the pencil. Whoops, with the pencil eraser brush. Okay, brush. Maybe I should use cloth. Oh, that's the one. That right there is. Not that one. It's. Totally forgot to turn it back up. Let's merge it down. Where's my merge? Oh. Merge it down. All right. Okay, in order to get that texture-y feel, I'm using Qual. The brush Qual is just my favorite brush. Thank you. Why do I have these lines? I think they're the tree. Yeah. Oh, it's on the tree layer. That's the problem. It's on the tree layer. Okay, now back to this layer and to my eraser brush. Thank you. my camera again. There we go. That's a little better, isn't it? Okay. And I'm really liking him. He looks very red on the camera, but he's not. He's quite brown. Carl is, that is. And I did the background here, so I'm going to close up that body. And I think I have an extra layer I can get rid of. Let me see what I want to do here. I think I want to get more greenery in the background here. So we're going to do... Actually, I don't know if I like this. Let's do that. Let's add another layer in the back. And I think I want kind of like, and my favorite brush. No. That's gonna darken it. I think maybe I need more yellow. Some different colors in the back. Okay. That I like. Yeah, okay, let me do it. And that's not the one I wanted. All right. See how easy it can be? You get confused about the layers. That's 100%. Is blocking. It's my 6B. Oh, is it 2B? No. What's going on here? Sometimes I have to reboot my iPad. A lot of layers, it can get easily confusing. right, let's do the time warp again. Let's see what qual looks like. Okay. Yep, we're gonna do qual clear. And then we're gonna do qual. I'm loving these guys. All right, let's get back to Hue. Had to change out my battery real quick, so let's get back to digital painting. Oh my gosh, having so much fun. Where was I? I was doing these guys with my green. Got my green, make sure I'm on the right layer. Yes, I am. All right, let's finish this up, and then I'll have to add the background. I just love this brush. Qual. Q H-O-O-Y-Q-U-O-L-L. These are the two main pencils I use. I do some other pencils, as you can see, but for the main, really this is it, and I just love it. Let me add some more dark here. Trees so you don't see through, but for now I'm okay with what I've got. I think why I like qual is because I can just layer it up and get it as small. I had to adjust it, of course, for what I like, but I can get it as small as a pencil. Or look at how wide I can get that. Because the edges are soft, I actually don't mind when it doesn't, I miss a spot like I'm doing here. And I'll show you what I'm talking about. After I do all of these, I'll get rid of everything in the foreground so you can see what I'm talking about. Right there. I gotta not do that. I do that and it spreads the ink on the pen just like a regular one. It spreads it wider. If I had a brush and it was full of water. I'll show you what I mean. Look at how beautiful these leaves are, these big bushy leaves here. And now I will get rid of all the background and show you what I mean. Let's get rid of you, Mr. Face. Oh, that's the next one. Okay. So let's make these guys complete. This is the part that's behind the Great Ape. But see all that texture? I absolutely love it, so I'm okay with it. Not blending all the way or being even. That's exactly what I want. see how. Trying to talk and do art at the same time. You see how the white shows through? That's exactly what I want. That's what I love in all of my art. Which of course means I may have to do book pages over the ones that I actually did over. Alright, anyways. Okay. So we're going to texture. Oh, I just love it. This is the brush, I'm telling you. Just had to learn how to use it properly. Okay. That's not the right one. I do that. I don't stick to the layers, so that's not good. See the difference on the size of the pen when I go like this, same as opposed to straight up and down. Sometimes I get to moving fast. Isn't that great? I love it. Okay, now this guy. we need. Okay, let me finish these guys. That one away from the monkey because we don't want it on his face, do we? No, we don't. Okay. So I think I want some yellow. Some lighter green to go underneath. Maybe not. Really like it. I'm just having a hard time deciding. Maybe I want to do white underneath. Let me get rid of all these. Oh, that's why. Clear. Because those go over there. This is what I want here. That's exactly. That's the look I'm looking for. See that? Beautiful. Thank you. See, it's got the lovely highlights on it. Oh, this is it. Okay. I think I started my books with these two. So, with these two tools, the number 6 pencil and quill. So, I won't have to redo too many of them, hopefully. Because it's a actual the quill brush tool, which I'm not sure, it's got a watercolor feel to it, but I've got the quill brush tool as my eraser tool as well, so that's why I have to go twice. It's not gonna erase it all. So this is with the this light greenish bluish color. Let's see, I'll show you right there. Well, it's not blue, greenish. I don't know why it has a little bit of blue tint to it. But so this is with that background and this is without. And so you can see how it pulls the highlights of the lighted areas. That is absolutely what I love. Absolutely what I want. And this is why I have to add the white backgrounds, so that I can have this appear within the artwork. Without the white background, it wouldn't work out the same. And I can add touch-ups and textures if I want with the 6B pencil. Last one on this layer. I'll just erase that. This one, putting a okay. I'm getting my Nope, that's not what I wanted. Okay. It's just lovely, and I don't mind the highlights at all. Okay. actually quite messy, and it looks so pretty. This layer and painting. We'll finish this up. I don't mind the highlights. Like right there. Don't mind that as much. But I do mind when the lines just don't look as good as they could. Already I can see I need to fix some things. Eraser this one. Eraser. So it's a little bit over edge there. Over edge there. The rest looks fine. And then this one. To the light layer, and we're going to finish that up. Again. That's all right. Let's fix this. Pretty low. Okay. Clean it up a little bit. Not too much, just a little bit. Oops. Thank you. little sloppy over here, didn't I? Maybe now I'll get excited about doing art when I'm exhausted after work. So let's bring it all together and take a good look at it and see where I want to make changes. Already I know I gotta move that flower. I think I might move it right here. But for now the rest looks great, except I do need to add white under the tree here. Let's do that. looks great, doesn't it? Except he needs to move. So, okay, I'm not gonna let's do. Okay. Like these guys. These guys are great. I think face and hands. I'm like, well, let's see, I need to do. I like that way better. Clear. And then let me go out. Okay. And then we'll get that. to actually make this, you know what I gotta do? I'm gonna make it into the stamp now, which is what started this whole thing. So I'm going to duplicate this file so I don't ruin my original. Great Ape Carl, Great Ape Carl. So I will take this one and remove all the background. That's the body. What is this one? Hair. Rename H-A-I-R hair, and then this one is the other. Okay, we're going to merge those. Merge with hair. Apple, face, hands. Okay, then, oh, need the tree. Let's see. Just hanging around, so I think leave it white. See, when you have the white, you can see the different colors in the back, which I don't mind because in the with the background you can't see it. But for the stamp, I don't want to have just random that, which is an ink layer. Whoops. And then I gotta find, this is body, and I want to see it's this one. Yep. Okay, so we're going to clean it up a little bit because we want our stamp to look artsy, but we also don't want it to be like, see, I like that hair. That actually is even good. Also, just clean it a little bit up. See, some of the areas are a little bit farther than I want them to be. On the colored background, it's okay. Sticking out because it's a different look than this one, and I want to just kind of break that up, but I like the rest of it. It's just not as uniform. Did I get on the right layer? Yep. And then like that. Just a little bit. There we go. All right. You are awesome, Great Ape. And make sure I've got him like I like him. So we're going to merge the body. Down. Oh, I do. I want actually. So we don't really need to worry about it. Right. I like that. Now, I think, let me see what I want to do. Do I want to do a white? I know what I want to do. Uniform. I want to make them smaller. Like that. Oh yeah, that's it. Okay. Then I want to clear you. Clear. And I want to do this again. Got that, so we're going to go around. Darn it. I think maybe I need to make him a little smaller. Okay. Get back on here. Get back with my monoline. I'm going to bring it all the way over here. Okay. And now we're this layer, actually clear this layer, clear. And I need to make you smaller. And then, like that, and then this guy. I think I want to just select this right there, and I want to start my work. And actually, I can add background now. That looks so great! I have to say I love it. And yeah. Okay, so this is going to be my sticker. How am I gonna do this? I want the sticker to go. Okay. Okay, we're gonna leave you like that, and then we're going to merge you guys. 6B pencil erase. I'm a little confused. What am I doing here? Okay, here's, in case I ruin this, let me fix this. Let me duplicate this one, because I need a backup. And this is Great Ape. Hello. Great Ape. Sticker. Done. And actually, here's what I need to do. Darn it. Oh well, I'll have to duplicate. Lock. And then this is the one I'm working on. Actually, I think I'm gonna have to monoline done. I'm just gonna delete it because it's I've got those. Can I inverse and delete it, I wonder? I know there's an easier way to do this, I just don't know what it is, so. So this is what I'm doing. See, you get complacent, you forget. I'm trying to make a stamp. So I like that. Oh, I didn't delete it. Oh my gosh, Naomi, you're just not real bright. See, I didn't delete it. I did white. Ugh. Which actually looks quite nice, though. I like it. Okay. So I think what I'm gonna do. Trying to figure out how and what I'm doing, because apparently I didn't cut that out. I just did a white layer, which is fine, because if I flatten it, it's essentially kind of a stamp. But this is kind of where I want to make an adjustment for this one. And actually, let me duplicate, let me hide that one, and then what am I doing? I'm wanting to adjust it, and I think I want to distort it. Actually, maybe I don't want to distort it. Yeah. I think I do. Is get on the right layer. This one. So that. Oh my goodness. Seriously, what am I doing? like that one halfway off. We're going to get rid of you. Off. I'm going to get rid of you. Oops. Off. Okay. I like that. I like that. And then too many plants. This makes me nervous, man. Let me just tell you. Okay. Just kind of I don't know. That's good. All right. Goodness. Okay, I like that. So what am I doing? No, this is so confusing. Okay. So we'll do that. I'm going to use monoline. Alright. And we're going to thank you. doing, I can't think. So even though I did it the hard way, which is erasing everything around the artwork, I do love the way my Great Ape Carl came out. Beautiful. So, after erasing all that, now I need to put the background in. This is the original, and of course I adjusted the size for the actual sticker. So now I need to add a layer, and now I can use the white and this one. And then what I'm going to do on this next layer in the white monoline brush is just go all the way around, just like that. Perfect. And then I can adjust it. Let me see, because I don't want it to be too big. Maybe a little bit. Maybe it needs a little bit more. That looks good. And now I'm going to do another one. So I need to do that. Don't want to. Sharp, because when you pull stickers off and the ends are too sharp, that's where it could rip. I don't want it to be too sharp. Alright, that looks good. Oops. Wow. That and then this one. I think I'm just going to do it like that. And this is going to go. My sticker looks good, huh? And this is what it looks like without the background. So there's the sticker. I think I'm gonna put some words just hanging around, so let me merge down, and then sketching. Maybe I'll try sketching. Just hanging out. Just hanging around. just hanging out. Do like that. Okay, let me clear that. Let me see what other options we have for lettering. I kind of like that, but I don't know if I like it in black. Maybe I'll do green. Let's see. Alright, where's my layer? Clear. Oops. Just. Just chilling, just hanging out. Hanging out. Oh, I'll just say hanging out. I liked the pencil one better, didn't I? Let's try this one. Hanging out. Okay, let's see. I like that. Hanging out. What do you think? Hanging out or hanging around? Very cool. I like it. I'm going to try and print this. Let's see what it looks like.